Welcome back to another Honcast.com presentation. I'm Bricky CPK, going to be your shoutcasting host, and joining me is Hippie of the Honcast staff, and this is once again our Honcast Daily here on Monday, 1 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. CET, same time every day, and today we're going to do a recap of at least one of the series that happened this past week, and in fact yesterday, for the Gosu Gamers Losers Bracket Semifinals. We got Online Kingdom taking on SK Gaming. It is going to be an awesome matchup here, one of two Losers Bracket matchups, and then of course there's the winner's bracket of Fnatic MSI versus EG. In total there's six teams remaining, and we are getting down to the nitty-gritty. The winner of this will move on to the loser's bracket finals, and eventually chance to of course play for the grand finals. There is $40,000 prize pool on the line. So much money. It's going to be a lot of awesome sauce. So with that said, we got a best out of three series here. Of course, this is being game one between Online Kingdom and SK Gaming. First things first though, like I said, I'm joined by Hippie of the Honcast staff. How you doing, Hippie?
Doing good. Two great teams coming up here. I've been loving this whole Gosu Gamers tournament. It's been a fantastic event, and we are drawing close to the end, which means we have better and better matches every time. Only the best teams left. Glad to see Loda playing again. Unless I've missed something, I haven't seen him for ages, and I kind of miss him. I mean, at first when he joined the scene, I wasn't really interested, but I saw some of his games, saw some of his old Dota games. He's really such a fun guy to watch.
Yeah, I mean, that is kind of funny, or not funny, I guess. I mean, it is interesting to see Loda actually back playing for Online Kingdom. They've actually been through several rosters throughout this whole tournament. I mean, just like some of all the teams have, perhaps, but Online Kingdom, of course, lately they have been through some recent changes, including losing Black and Semiju to both TSOG and Dirty Minds, but we do see Semiju. He is actually stepping up to play for Online Kingdom. You know, he started an event with the team. You know, it does make sense to, of course, finish it with them, and they are pretty far at this point where they are getting a decent amount of money from competing in this event, so why not finish it off strong and see what you can make happen. So definitely an inconsistent roster, but with that said, all very, very, very skilled players, so that's what it comes down to with a team like this and Online Kingdom, whether or not their individual skills can make up really for the lack of practice time, the lack of coordination that, you know, they just really can't have between one another because, again, they've used so many different rosters. As far as SK Gaming is concerned, we're looking at a much more consistent roster lately, including Angry Testing. You know, he's been back. He's been active with the team. And then we got Fog, Tobacco, Trafalmador, and B-Diz. So always very, very entertaining players over there. And I'm looking for a hell of a matchup. I really think it should be. Again, getting this far in the tournament, you can't expect anything less than a great, great, great matchup. So with that said, let's actually jump into the bans, of course, and I want to make a quick reminder. B-Diz made a nice mention here in the chat of any nerds doing the replay cast looking at you, Bricky CPK, so that would be me. Both new heroes are mutually auto-banned, so thanks, shout out to B-Diz right there for letting us know right off the bat. So he's by that he means, of course, Moraxes and Myrmidon, so those are both auto-banned. With that said, the other bans we're looking at: Swiftblade, Forsaken Archer, Bombardier, Pebbles, Pharaoh, and Tundra. So Dr. Repulsor, of course, the first standout that was not banned this game, and as we see, Online Kingdom snatched him up right away. As far as the other bans, really a couple of interesting ones. We got Swiftblade and Forsaken Archer. Those are two that we don't see too often, but we have seen from time to time simply because of certain players you're playing against, and you know that they pretty much dominate with those heroes. So other than that, though, the four other bans, you know, pretty consistent bans.
Yeah, definitely, and I think that the Dr. Repulsor not being banned, SK instantly picked up Witch Slayer and Bubbles, two very, very powerful counters to that Dr. Repulsor. You got the chain disable on Witch Slayer and the silence coming down on Bubbles. So it looks like they're doing the thing that we've seen recently of some teams trying not banning Dr. Repulsor, saving the ban for something else, and trying to just pick a couple good, solid heroes that fit well into their lineup, but that also counter Dr. Repulsor very strong, or in a very strong way. And hopefully we'll see that work out for them, because I'm kind of sick of seeing Dr. Repulsor just take over games like he does and then get banned all the time.
Yeah, I mean, this was interesting at the DYA event as well, again, which we did recently, and we did see several times where, in fact, Dr. Repulsor wasn't banned, and we even saw one series, I believe it was between EG and ICE in the qualification, or the round-robin phase, where he wasn't even banned or picked up, so that was interesting there, but it does seem like we have more and more teams, you know, willing to try recently, at least the whole, we're not going to ban this Dr. Repulsor, we're going to, you know, let the other team first pick him, or we're going to maybe let it go on further and see who gets him. But of course, Online Kingdom, they are the ones to pick him up here, and we will see what they can accomplish with that hero, as I do believe that they first picked him. So With that said, we're now loading into the game. I do want to make a quick reminder, again, for those people that are constantly asking about the EG versus MSI matchup for the winner's bracket, it was supposed to take place yesterday, but unfortunately, they once again had to postpone it. So, from my understanding, it's not going to happen until next week. And now, of course, with being a U.S. versus European team, it's kind of hard to get matched up during the weekdays. So, they are going to have to play, you know, on the weekend. So, with that said, it looks like either next Saturday or Sunday is going to be the date and to get that matchup going. So, of course, we will keep people posted and updated on when exactly that should happen. But this series, as well as a DWI versus our Dirty Mind series, they actually happen. So, yeah, that's a quick reminder right there. But let's go do a sync up real quickly while we just got into the game, of course. So I'm looking at the game timer, currently at 35, 34, 33, 32, 31, 30, 29, 28, 27.
I'm good.
All right. Okay, so good to go. All right, with that said, let's go over the Legion team real quickly. Legion team being Online Kingdom, we are looking at Behemoth, Tempest, Dr. Repulsor, Glacius, and Corrupted Disciple. Corrupted Disciple, not a carry hero we've seen a whole lot lately, but definitely has a lot of power. You know, there was this time in the meta game where he was very, very powerful and really picked up constantly. But ever since the Trilin really was introduced, really haven't seen all too much of him. But it looks like Online Kingdom here, in fact, they're going to be looking to run a Trilin with Corrupted Disciple. Looking forward to seeing how that turns out for them. And of course, seeing Kabob play Behemoth, speaking of him, you know, he's been kind of on and off lately in terms of his play. Good to see him back as well. Awesome Behemoth player. All around though, a solid lineup. Again, Dr. Pulsar stand out. It's Glacius, by the way, just in the middle lane, so it looks like 2-2-1 setup, in fact. But yeah, very, very, very sound lineup. Again, Corrupted Disciple, I haven't seen him too often lately, but albeit a very powerful hero, so not really necessarily questionable. And you do have to keep in mind, again, Swiftblade and Forsaken Archer were both banned this game. So what do you think about the Legion team over here, Hippie?
Well, what really stands out to me is that they have a combination that was almost always banned or not allowed to be picked up way, way back in closed beta, which is the AoE combination of Tempest and Behemoth. If they can get a good, you know, Blink Tempest ult, and followed up with a good Blink Behemoth ult, that is absolutely devastating. I don't know how many people have been watching since closed beta, but if you know anything about how those two ultimates work, you know how powerful that is, and you know how much damage they do. So I'm interested to see how that plays out during teamfights. I think if they get the initiation off, they have the clear teamfight advantage, but at the same time, you have heroes over on the Hellborn like Bubbles who can help to shut that down if they don't quite take him out. It looks like they're actually running a 2-2 none with Tempest in the jungle, which is kind of what I saw coming. Just because we've seen so many teams just put a hero in the jungle instead of in the tri-lane. And if you know there's going to be a tri-lane, why not just pick a jungle hero? You're not going to get any farm against it, especially when Tempest is such a powerful ganking hero from the jungle. We've seen a lot of games, and I mean, throughout the course of competitive Heroes of New Earth, from closed beta to now, where a good jungling Tempest comes in, gets the ganks going, and really, really takes over lanes, shuts people down. The classic Fabi Nighthounds game way, way back when was really all about the ganking Tempest and the ganking Magnus, I believe it was in that game. It was very, very powerful.
Yeah, I apologize. I kind of just skimmed over Tempest as if it wasn't a big deal. I didn't even really think to mention that when I was going over the lineup, but wow, holy crap, they have Tempest. So Tempest is a rare pickup here in competitive games as well. I was just talking so much about Corrupted Disciple, but looking at Tempest, I haven't seen him in a long time. But again, as you stated, you know, it has been curious why we haven't seen, because we do see several times where whenever a team is going up against an obvious trial lane, and in this case, of course, it would have been the Pestilence trial lane for SK Gaming, why not just pick up a jungle hero and just send it to the jungle and, you know, let him get the free farm like he was going to get, unless you plan on matching up with the Tri versus Tri, which, of course, Online Kingdom wasn't planning on doing. So I am really curious to see how this works up, because I believe this is the first time we have seen a jungle-style hero picked up to, you know, kind of go against a tri-lane strategy and see how it works out here for Online Kingdom. Right now, though, Semi-Jury actually pushed to the top lane. I guess he wanted to stop that tower push happening from Pestilence, so porting up here right now. Needs to be careful as Andromeda's coming in, but the quick stun in Andromeda actually will prevent any powerful initiation, and Tempest just falling back to the tower, so did, you know, cause Andromeda to start roaming up to the top lane as a result of seeing Tempest up there and trying to distract him a little bit, but of course Tempest falling back. Right now he is losing a little bit of experience in Gold Farm, of course, but again, it's kind of curious if this is what their plan is. You know, every time Pestilence gets a little bit of a tower push, send him up there, you know, kind of scare him off a little bit, and then maybe look to go back to the jungle buff. Right now he's in there. There comes the Comet Star coming out, and followed by the Impale Star. Will Simiji be able to get out of here? He has a stun. He's going to use it smartly on Pestilence right there, and he should easily be able to get away, and of course he is. So great getaway there by Simiju. But again, the pressure being applied from the Hellborn team, and they're really making sure Tobacco on Pestilence gets a very, very powerful farm. Of course, an early portal key will be huge, especially against a counter team from this Legion team when they have a Tempest and a Behemoth. You want to get the early portal key so you can initiate first and not have to wait for them. So that's going to be a huge pickup for Pestilence, of course. With that said, let's go over the Hellborn team real quickly now. We got Witch Slayer, Soul Stealer, Pestilence, Bubbles, and Andromeda. We do have action in the middle lane. Oh, I'm sorry. Kind of overtalking you there, but yeah, it looks like Glacius is going to get away and nothing's going to happen out of that. But Hellborn team, I've been talking too much. What are your thoughts on the Hellborn team?
Well, Hellborn team, again, they have some very powerful blink initiation in Pestilence, and he is getting that pretty much free farm at the top lane. I like the fact that that they brought Semiju up on Tempest to try and control the lane a little, because actually a really good player with really excellent micro can control a 1v2 lane if they play carefully with Tempest, thanks to the elementals, thanks to being able to stun and get out of dodge if you notice someone coming in to get the stun out on you, etc. So I think that's a good choice, and if Semiju plays it well, he's going to be able to slow down Tobacco. He won't be able to prevent the portal key because he can't really get solo kills, so unless someone moves to the top to help him gank, he'll be okay. But I do like that. As far as the Hellborn team goes, they have good non-blink initiation, which is something that the Legion team kind of lacks. They have, I guess, Dr. Repulsor, but at the same time, he's not really perfect because if he gets chain CC'd as soon as he goes in, he doesn't have enough AoE CC type abilities. He doesn't have like the silence or the kelp field like Bubbles does to really shut down the enemy team as soon as he blinks in. So I do like them in that respect. At the same time, I think once blinks are coming out on both teams, I still think OK has the advantage there. Really good CC all around on the Hellborn team, which I think is very, very important with this Dr. Repulsor in the game. And hopefully they'll be able to keep him down. I mean, the only hero without some kind of CC that is perfectly good against that Dr. Repulsor is Angry Testy on Soul Stealer. And when you have him, he can just burst Dr. Repulsor down while he's CC'd, hopefully. Very powerful AoE coming out all over, and we do see Bubbles looking to blink in the middle lane. They get a stun on Dr. Repulsor, but Bubbles does not actually follow up with that turtle ship. Lots of action back and forth here. I think overall, I probably prefer the Legion team. I think they should win most team fights, but it depends on what kind of farm this Soul Stealer gets, what kind of farm Tobacco gets on that Pestilence if he goes. If he gets like active and gets a ganking style Pestilence going, once he gets his portal key, he gets very, very active in setting up kills around the map. They could really keep down this entire Legion team to the extent where they just can't get their blinks going, and then they'd have a definite advantage.
Oh yeah, no doubt, and I was actually going to mention this as well, of course. Whenever you see Tempest as well, if he's going to be in the lane especially, expect them to do a push-style strategy, and right now we see the Legion team 7 minutes into the game, going for a push here on the bottom tower, easily taken out, absolutely no defense set up. Bubbles was nearby, but of course nothing he was going to do, so, you know, that is an advantage of having a hero like Tempest in the lane. Very, very powerful pusher with those minions as shown right there. Again, going back to that Dr. Pulsar, as you said, you are correct. A lot of stun, a lot of CC on the Hellborn team. But with that said, Dr. Pulsar, you got to figure he's going to work towards a Shrunken Head. And when he gets that Shrunken Head, you know, will be pretty powerful in terms of going in and going out and setting up some powerful initiation himself and looking to maybe catch heroes like a Pestilence, preventing them from initiating first. And, you know, getting those portal keys, though, on Tempest, on Behemoth, are going to be overall the important thing. Without those, Dr. Pulsar can jump in and out all he wants. But if he doesn't have the good follow-up, then they can't expect much to happen from it. So yeah, the portal keys on both Tempest and Behemoth are going to be huge. Of course, we'll keep an eye on that throughout the game. Right now, Tempest really isn't doing that good of a job himself, even, at getting a powerful farm. Again, he spent a lot of time here at this top lane trying to prevent Pestilence from getting a true farm. He was in the jungle initially, but then they just decided to go away from that strategy, and they wanted to prevent Pestilence from overall getting a strong push. So it seems kind of like a mix-up, but at the same extent, you know, again, at least they got the tower push, and they did apply a little bit of pressure now to this top tower, dropping it to half-life. But we saw the ports coming in from the Hellborn team. Something else I believe we forgot to mention as well about the Hellborn team, the minus armor from them. You were looking at Andromeda, Soulstealer, and Pestilence, of course. That's a very powerful trio right there. We have seen them several times in the past. A lot of minus armor right there between those three heroes, and that could prove to be very, very deadly, as we've seen so many times for just really any hero in the game. As Pestilence, by the way, he gets initiated on right here. There goes the finish trying to stun him. Is it going to be enough? Runs back in, throws the Impelstone, Corrupted Disciple trying to chase, but a great call is done from Andromeda, blocking Corrupted Disciple, and now here we go. Corrupted Disciple actually gets turned around on. Tempest also going to get taken out, and Behemoth playing a little bit. Oh my god, what am I going to do type deal. He avoids it for long enough. Oh, but Witchslayer spots him, and now they realize he's in the jungle. Tries to throw the Fissure Stone. Not going to happen. And down goes Behemoth as well. Angry Testy on Soulstealer with the hero kill right there. And here comes a counter push now from SK Gaming. So well played on their part. A 3-0 hero kill advantage just like that. And in fact, that was the Bloodlust kill. So finally seen the Bloodlust kill, but hey, at least we got it right here. Dr. Pulsar, though, he's gonna pour it in. Angry Testy in a lot of trouble. Gets the stun right there. The slow Corrupted Disciple and Glacius running in. There's the Electric Tide trying to finish him off. Yes, they will get the kill. Bubbles does not pour it in, but he's looking to run in now. Andromeda also chasing out of mana completely, though. So is Witch, so he does have enough for a graveyard stun. But Pestilence does enough to chase down Dr. Pulsar. Gets the kill on him. Behemoth now back in the fight. Great graveyard stun right there, though. Stunning both of them. Behemoth now running up, trying to land a good fissure. Will get it off. Prep the Disciple charges him. Bubbles. He does not have enough mana for a turtle shot. He throws around with the silence, but he's more than likely. No, a great save from Pestilence right there with the Impale Sun. Gotta save Bubbles. Well, Pestilence might be in trouble himself. Is he actually gonna get away? It looks like he is as well. Great team support right there. What is still happening? And no one actually ended up dying right there. Holy crap. Several players solo on life. But in the end, no one dies after that final skirmish, and both teams gonna fall back and get some regeneration going on. So well played from both teams, as of course we're now looking at a 4-1 hero kill advantage in favor of the Hellborn team now.
Yeah, I think it was a little bit sloppy of Angry Testy to play up so far with all the respawns happening, but at the same time, you know, he came back into the fight as soon as he could. He got some good nukes off. He pushed the Hellborn, or the Legion team back, and prevented them from making that tower push, finishing off that tower, which definitely would have gone down if he hadn't blinked in, or poured it in, thrown out those demon hands, pushed back the creeps. Really, really clutch save by Tobacco, though. That was really well played, getting the stun off and still managing to get out.
Apparently, see Angry Testy having some issues here with his computator. Okay, they're ready, so I was going to say let's do fast forward, but it looks like he is good to go. Okay. Speaking of that, by the way, what server are we playing on? It is a European server. Okay. Always curious to check that out in these series here. Again, this is only game one. It's a best out of three series, so first one, though, being played on a European server here. Tempest going to port to the bottom lane, prevent the tower push from happening from those creeps. Pestilence, he's got to be getting fairly close to a portal key himself, around 1,500 gold saved up. Of course, going for the steam boots first, typical there. And but again, that portal key, as always, going to be huge for him, so another 650 gold or so will have it. Again, Tempest and Behemoth, neither one of them really getting a powerful farm. Tempest, okay, but you don't expect him to have the portal key very, very soon. It's going to take him a little bit. He did choose to go Blood Chalice first and Ring of the Teacher. Curious if he chooses to go something like a bottle as well. You know, boots. We see different style of builds from Tempest. We've seen they just completely rush for Portal Key. We've also seen they get a lot of regeneration, get the boots, and then eventually go for a type deal, depending on your farm. As, by the way, Pestilence got jumped on right there in the middle lane. Great execution right there, and that's Dr. Pulsar for you, especially if against one hero like that. He can jump in like that, catch you off guard, pull you in, and great follow-up from the Legion team, so slowing down Pestilence a little bit from getting that fast portal key. Going to clean up this middle lane now and perhaps push this middle tower. Tempest is not with them, but they still got a lot of damage, and they got the creep wave to their advantage, so we'll see if the Hellborn team reacts to this. Bubbles is lining up. Looks like he may look to initiate coming from behind a couple of Soulstealer illusions, so course, not going to do too much with that. And Witch Slayer pinging the bottom lane. I guess thought the rune may have been there. But, of course, it was top, as we already see Angry Testy picking it up, as it indeed was the Illusion Rune. So Pestilence now ports back to the top lane. Once again, still working on that portal key after getting ganked right there. But he should have in the next couple of minutes or so. And we'll see if SK Gaming looks to take advantage of that. But, you know, going back to the whole minus armor thing as well, definitely look for SK Gaming, especially with them being Hellbored. Look for them to try to take the opportunity of ninjing a Kongor kill in here. Because, again, that is just so much minus armor. Even at, you know, just the level 6s or so, I mean, early on, you're looking at easily, you know, like around minus 10 armor with all the abilities, and you could just drop Kongor so fast. So we'll see if they go for an earlier Kongor kill. That's always very beneficial for these competitive games.
Yeah, I think it was actually Fogs who brought that up on one of my previous guests, and that he's first picking these minus armor type heroes when he's on Hellborn, simply because of the fact that you have that Kongor advantage. You can get to him and bring him down before Legion can react if you pushed in those first two towers, just because Legion has the distance between Legion second tower and Hellborn second tower to Kongor. There's a massive, massive difference in runtime. So if you push in just that middle Legion tower, you can pretty much take a free Kongor with all this minus armor.
That you can. And Legion team, again, there's not too much they can do to react to it fast enough, of course, especially without those portal keys. But when they get those portal keys, that's where the Hellborn team, they would need to be a little bit worried, because they, of course, they'll be clumped up in that Kongor pit. It pretty much forces you to be. And if that is the case, yeah. You do not want to be clumped up against the Legion team. But look at this action at the top lane, trying to finish out the tower, but Port's coming in at the last second, and the Hellborn team will be able to deny it. Everyone is currently up here. We see Tempest up in the jungle, but he's actually going to port to the top tower and meet up with his team, but it doesn't look like either team's going to truly initiate. In fact, Corrupt the Disciple, he's already back at the base, so... excuse me there. Anyways, Corrupt the Disciple now, he's going to actually port back to the middle lane and continue his farm. He's, by the way, picking up a Mighty Blade. So, again, we were talking about that earlier. Dr. Pulsar's, you know, more than likely a Shrunken Head would be a valuable item. We'll see if Corrupt the Disciple chooses to go that route as well. There is a good amount of CC coming out from this Hellborn team, and definitely a valid option item choice, of course. Semi-G on Tempest taking a little bit of pressure right there from Bubbles, but going to fall away. And you see Corrupt the Disciple, though, he's actually getting caught right here as Bubbles with the ultimate comes out. There's that portal key passes, stunning in on Corrupt the Disciple. The Soul Stealer ultimate as well, way off to the side, but it did do enough damage to help get the kill at least on Corrupt the Disciple. We also see cleanup on a couple of more heroes in Tempest and Glacius, and SK Gaming gonna push the middle tower. They should easily be able to take it out, as three heroes are dead just like that for the Legion team.
Yeah, really, really excellent catch by Trouble Northern Rift there, playing that bubble, dropping the Kelp Field on that Corrupted Disciple, knowing that he didn't have the support close enough to shut him down. They had the Blinking from Pestilence, just a quick takedown on Corrupted Disciple, and a real great setup for that team fight, getting the middle three tower push. And like I said, with that middle tower down, it's going to become very, very easy for them to take Kongor whenever they want to. I'd say expect them to go for it around the 20-25 minute mark when they get a pickoff on an important hero. Say if they manage to pick off Behemoth or Tempest, I'd say they'd go right in for it.
See Soulstealer clean out this bottom line. Of course, thankfully it has a regen rune, so it can spam those demon hands and not worry too much. Now full man and full life. Him, speaking of himself, he's also got a Mighty Blade, just like the Corrupted Disciple. So, again, Soulstealer, you more than likely would figure it would be a Shrunken Head for him, but we will see. Of course, you know, obviously Portal Key not a popular item, but when you already have the powerful initiation from Pestilence, maybe not as necessary, although you could definitely argue having the Portal Key would be a good follow-up to a Pestilence, putting you right in a good spot to get a good ultimate off. So we will see if he still looks to go for that in the long run, but it doesn't look like he's at least going to go for it first. As we see, of course, again from the Mighty Blade, as it looks like, yeah, he was just delivered the Warhammer, so he is going for a Shrunken Head first. Again, you know, as always, a very, very comfortable item, very, pretty much an item that can be useful in all games, and, well, more so, or again, looking back at this game, definitely has every reason to be. So, looking more at items, actually, while I'm doing that. Andromeda, nothing too much, just a ward bitch. Nothing to see here, folks. Bubbles, he's got Steam Boots in his Blood Chalice. Not doing too shabby. Okay, not doing too great, but he's not doing too bad. Although his farm is actually 268 gold per minute, so actually is a lot better than showing him his items. Of course, we already talked about the portal key on Pestilence. And he's now sprinting over to somewhere. Oh, look at this, though. He's near Congra, and this is what I was talking about. Are they going to go for the early Congra attempt? The Swarm is put up. You see Andromeda coming in with the Aurora, and already level 3, so we got minus 4 from that, minus 6, or minus 5 from this, so we got minus 9. And then, of course, the Aura minus 2. So minus 11 armor right now on a Congra. And, I mean, you just look at how fast he drops. We're only 17 and a half minutes into the game. And Congo is just going to get annihilated right here. And the Legion team, I don't even think they know. I mean, they are kind of lining up over here, so maybe they do, but yeah, it's just there's just nothing they can do. Pestilence is going to pick up the Token of Life. And just like that, SK Gaming just took a much, much bigger lead with that Congo kill. So it's not looking good for Online Kingdom. It really isn't. I mean, both Loda and Magix on Corrupted Disciple and Dr. Pulse, their farm isn't too bad. I mean, they actually are doing decent, but honestly, without those portal keys on Behemoth and Tempest, they cannot expect much to happen. So right now, I think that's ultimately what is going to be the biggest deal for Online Kingdom. They need those portal keys on at least one of those heroes, ideally both of them, if they really want to have a chance right now, because both Pestilence and Solstice are getting crazy farmed up, and right now, SK Gaming definitely has the initiation favor.
Yeah, absolutely. I think with just the portal key on Semijew, they can get the setup with the Striders. He can run in fast enough to get his ultimate off. Just drop that Behemoth ultimate right in the middle of them, but obviously it is preferable to have that Behemoth as well. Especially then if the Tempest ultimate doesn't quite go off, maybe you want to hit with the Behemoth first. Although we do see Tempest not going for that portal key, he just picked up a Beast Heart. So, interesting choice. I'm not a big fan. I think, well, yes, hit points are always good. At the same time, he desperately needs that Warren team. They're not going to win this fight. Now, Warren team already has a huge teamfight advantage. They have the initiation advantage for as long as they have those blinks. Tralfamador just picked up his blink on Bubble. So, looking at this, you need a way to initiate against this Hellborn team, and they don't really have a particularly good one, except for this Dr. Repulsor. And without the proper blink follow-up for Dr. Repulsor, he's just going to blink in and get popped. They have too much CC. Can't do anything.
Very, very true. As I turned your volume up a little bit, I mean, you sound fine on my end, but there are people complaining and they can't hear you too well, so if you want to tune yourself up a little bit yourself as well, might be helpful. But in the meantime, we do have the Hellborn team initiating here on the bottom lane. Of course, already taking out that secondary tower and already applying pressure to this base tower. Again, just no really strong initiation from this Legion team without those portal keys, so the best thing they can do is turtle up. And, well, especially with the Behemoth, you know, they can definitely do that effectively, so. Right now, they're pretty much all playing a defense here at their base. It looks like a Hellborn team, they thought about backing off, but they're going to wait for the next creep wave and actually go back in right here. Fidgerstone coming out once again. On a Soul Steal, their Corrupted Disciple runs in. Oh, but look at this! Pestilence jumps on top of Corrupted Disciple. The portal key from Witchler as well. The Silver Bullet follow-up, and just like that, Corrupted Disciple is taken out. Here we go with the Tempest Ultimate, but the Shrunken Head, as well as they get him knocked out of it. Soul Steal, they're doing a lot of damage. He's dropping fast, though, and Soul Steal will actually go down as the Behemoth Ultimate goes off, so it could take right there. And now Pestilence trying to run away. Andromeda very low. Witchler also very low. And in the end, they all fall back. Pestilence still has a Token of Life, but really big-time overextension right there from the Hellborn team, and kind of, you know, put themselves in places for a Tempest Ultimate and a Behemoth Ultimate. And, well, in the end, it's a 2-for-2 exchange, and the tower still remains at half life. So you can definitely suggest that SK Gaming perhaps shouldn't have jumped in all crazy like that. But you can definitely see their reasoning somewhat. They got the opportunity to pick off Corrupted Disciple, and they did. It's just in the end, though, Dr. Repulsor was able to deal enough damage himself, as well as, again, between Behemoth and Tempest, their abilities to get the job done. So actually a good defensive stand right there in the end for Online Kingdom. And yes, a bit of overplay, but hey, they'll take that. And we do see Shrunken Head, by the way, finished on Dr. Repulsor. So, of course, as we were talking about earlier, very powerful item for him, especially in this game with a lot of CC coming out. So, well, good stand, and, you know, even though Corrupted Disciple died, Online Kingdom showing at least that you can make some stands without those portal keys. And, well, I was going to say, what is the... Ooh, Tempest actually picking up a Beast Heart. So, spending 1,100 gold on a Beast Heart, he now has 850 gold saved up. Interesting. I mean, he could add a portal key very, very shortly if he did not go for that Beast Heart. But he wants the survivability, so...
Yeah, I mentioned it earlier, I don't agree with it. I think they need the blink so badly, they need the initiation. On top of that, yeah, massive overextension from SK. It's really because their support heroes are still, and all of them are still really too under-leveled and under-farmed to be tanking that tower at the same time as their team fighting. Like you said, I saw what they were going for with the Corrupted Disciple pickoff, but I mean, the highest level is level 12. They don't really have a huge amount of hit point items. I mean, Soul Stealer only has 1,200 hit points. Those tower hits hurt him a lot. Pestilence only has 1,500. Working on his shrunken head almost has it, actually. Just needs the recipe. And he's about 1,000 gold away from that. Angry Testy sitting on about 2,400 gold. Wonder what he's farming up there. I think I would like the portal key. I think it would be good. I think a good follow-up, because you're going to have a lot of nice disable. You're going to have the kelp field and the silence to... Oh, we do see initiation going here. Nice swap by Andromeda to save Bubbles there. Dr. Pulse are going to go in. They're going to pick off that token of life on Pestilence. Bubbles trying desperately to get out of there. Behemoth ultimate onto Pestilence. Trying to get the stone off. Blaze's ultimate comes out, but he does go down. However, Tobacco looks like he is going to get picked off on that Pestilence, trying to get out there. Nice catch by the Legion team, burning that token of life and getting that Pestilence down. They may have lost two people to do it. It's disappointing that they lost Corrupted Disciple. If they could have done it without losing Corrupted, then that would have been obviously a superior fight for them. But at the same time, getting that token of life off of Pestilence is huge, because he doesn't have that confidence level when he blinks in anymore.
Yeah, on top of that, again, we did see the shrunken heads going off from Corrupted. Actually, whoa, what is going on down here? Glacius going to get picked off by Witchslayer and Bubbles. Tempest trying to turn this around. Finish Stun comes out, and Witchslayer dropping fast. He has a great block right there for the Finish Stun from Behemoth, and now Bubbles got a standing still. Oh, boy, Bubbles might be in trouble himself. He does not have a Shell Surf for another 8 seconds or so. He throws out the Silence. He uses the take cover right there, but it's not going to be enough, and Bubbles also gets taken out, so at what cost right there? Oh, and Andromeda in the meantime going to go down. Soul Stealer, oh, it looks like Soul Stealer is going to be able to get away with the Homecoming still, but again, SK Gaming going for too much in the end and really giving the opportunity to Online Kingdom to have a good comeback right there and get some solid kills himself. So well played, but Pestilence has not finished just yet. He jumps in, puts a swarm up with the Impale. The Shrunken Head immediately activated from Dr. Pulsar. What a Fissure Stun from Behemoth right there. Blocks Pestilence, and unless he can portal key on top of him right here, the stop comes out from Behemoth. Kabob showing off his skills right there. Oh, Pestilence, you might be in some trouble now. Here comes the Tempest Stun right here. Starting at three times in a row. Glacius also here throws out the freeze. Pestilence will be going down as well. Oh my god, what play from Online Kingdom, especially from Kabob right there, as I mentioned. An awesome Behemoth player, and showing why once again right there. But overall, really just great team support from Online Kingdom. But again, SK Gaming, they really are getting greedy here, as we've seen several times, going back to that team fight in the base to right there. They're going overextension big time. They really want these kills, and they've had the advantage throughout this game, but you know, they're kind of letting it slip away, honestly. Right now, Helm of the Black Legion, in fact, finished on Tempest, so I do apologize. You did mention that earlier. Again, I got a little bit distracted at that time, but Helm of the Black Legion picked up on Tempest, so he wants to be able to avoid, you know, a lot of damage coming out on himself. And then Behemoth, you know, he's going to be looking pretty good at his portal key, as well as Tempest. So, very, very good pickups there for the Legion team. As everyone's going to have to take care of that, because people love abusing the chat system. All right. Anyways, so yeah. Well, Online Kingdom, I mean, as scary as it was looking for them early on, again, you know, SK Gaming has kind of let them, you know, sneak back in this one. And with those portal keys, as we said from the very beginning, going to be picked up. In fact, Tempest now has enough gold for his. He just bought it right there. Behemoth will have his in a matter of 350 gold or so. This game is, as far as I'm concerned, it's basically back to even.
Yeah, I agree. How are my levels now, by the way?
That sounds fine. Sound good to me.
Alright, cool. I,
I mean, like I said, I wasn't a fan of not getting the portal key on Tempest earlier, but at the same time, he has it now, so at this point it doesn't matter, and he's got the Helm of the Black Legion on top of it, so he is really sitting pretty. And like you said, with Behemoth going to have his soon, what needs to happen now definitely is that the Hellborn team, they need to look for Tempest, they need to initiate on Tempest with the Blinks and pick him off before he can get that ultimate off in teamfight. Because that's going to be their saving grace, is they have the Blinks, they have the Silences, stuff like that, that they can get this Tempest and get this Behemoth before they can get their abilities off. And that's really, really key, because the Legion team has a definite teamfight advantage if they can get that that Elemental Void on just two or three players and not get him stunned out of it. Especially once Tempest, I would assume he's going to be going for a Shrunken Head in the very near future. Which should be, I mean, if you can't stun him out of that, they don't have, I believe, well, they do have the Kelp Field, with the Superior Magic and the Swap that'll stun
tablet,
him anyway.
Tablet, I believe, as well. But or did they change that recently?
Tablet no longer
okay,
goes
yeah,
for Shrunken
okay,
Head.
That's right, yeah.
But they do have the Swap and the Kelp Field, both of which will. So the goal, I guess, will be if they can catch the Bubbles and the Andromeda once he has a Shrunken Head, and it looks like they might be going for another Kongor here, but the Legion team does have Vision this time. So I wonder if we'll see them try to counter it. But at the same time, Kongor drops so fast with all that minus armor.
It does, but this is what I was talking about earlier as well, because, you know, what really made them comfortable was the lack of portal keys from the Legion team as, whoa, Corrupted Disciple. Kind of just figuring that they were doing it, he charges in there right there with his ultimate and Shrunken Head, but clearly that wasn't the case, so wasting a cooldown right there, unfortunately. A couple of cooldowns, in fact, and now the Hellborn team, we'll see if, I mean, obviously that's not necessarily a huge ultimate, that the big ultimates that they're worried about are the Tempest and Behemoths, so although, yes, Corrupted Disciple, this is down right now. Yeah?
More important than the fact that he burns the cooldowns, that the Shrunken Head is on cooldown.
Here we go. Yes, you're exactly right. And right there, he gets picked off between Bubbles and Pestle. So Corrupted Disciple already out of the fight. Still see the jump in as well. He cannot get his ultimate off. There we go. The Shrunken Head. Oh, tries to get off. He cancels it, actually, figuring it wasn't worth it. Great cancel right there. Glacius will get away, but the Legion team got completely spread out right there. And we do see both Tempest and Behemoth getting picked off. So, again, even though they have the portal keys, the Hellborn team can initiate first, like they did right there, they will win the team fight. So well played right there from the Hellborn team, catching them off guard. And well, that time it definitely was not overextension. It was just very, very smart play from the Hellborn team. Token of Life once again picked off on Pestilence as they just absolutely annihilate Conga right there. And Pestilence is actually very close. In fact, I think he just finished his own Shrunken Head. So Shrunken Heads are just very popular items throughout this game, of course, as we both expected on really both teams. And that's going to be once again a huge item for them. Of course, it doesn't stop the Tempest Ultimate, nor does it stop the initial damage from the Behemoth Ultimate, but it will stop, of course, the follow-up effect damage from the Behemoth Ultimate. So it still has some great use to it. Between, you also look at Dr. Repulsor and Glacius, relying a lot on magic, of course. And, yeah. So anyways, speaking of Dr. Repulsor, by the way, he's got a sustainer.
Yeah, I mean, even Corrupted Disciple in the early game, when he's still building his survivability items, is very much a magic-reliant carry, in that he has to be able to get his conduit off on heroes to really get good damage out in team fights. His electric tide spam is a lot of good damage. Nice pick off there in the bottom lane.
Indeed, as Behemoth jumped in and used his ultimate, we see the Shrunken Head activated, though, on both Souls Tutor and Pest. Seen a lot of gold heroes today. Great job by Behemoth, though. He wants to follow up on this Pestilence. But, Tempest does get the stun off. They might actually be able to do this. Demon Head's coming out from Souls Tutor, though. And, wow, Tempest just got annihilated right there. The rest of the team was not able to follow up. Again, you see Dr. Repulsor was just really out of mana. So that was just a lack of communication right there from the Legion team. They should have announced that. And as much as they really wanted to get that kill, it just was not going to be worth it. And, in the end, ends up going bad for them, so.
Yeah, and on top of that, they didn't expect the Bubbles to be coming in. I think if they had known Bubbles was there, they definitely would have backed off, but they didn't expect the Blink. He went in, he nuked down Semiju right there with the help of Soulstealer. I mean, there's Bubbles is such... He has such amazing control in his zone. Like, if he can get close to you, he can lock down your whole team in so many different ways. It's fantastic. I love that hero, I'm sorry.
Indeed. Oh, Dr. Repulsor, you're in a lot of trouble, buddy. Silver Bullet comes out with Bubbles as well, porting in. And a really easy kill for them right there. So, great coordination. That's good, you know, just roaming around, setting up some nice ganks, and of course that early portal key on Witch Slayer as well. It's something we referred to, but a very, very powerful pickup right there. Soul Stealer, by the way, he's going to bottle up this Haste Rune, and to mention Geometer's Bane. So he's doing a good amount of damage himself now with the initiation that they have. And speaking of initiation, Pestilence goes on the finish on the kind of blocking, though. And here we go with a Tempest Ultimate. That's actually a really good Tempest Ultimate. Pestilence and Andromeda will drop right there. Soulstealer, though, he's going to get off his Ultimate, doing a good check of damage. Pestilence, of course, resurrecting with the Token of Life. Corrupted Disciple dropping fast. And down goes Corrupted Disciple. But Soulstealer and Pestilence, it looks like they're going to both try to run away right here. And yes, they are. So the Token of Life, very big right there, again, as it usually is. Is, but it's of course it resurrects him and they're able to follow up. But great job from Online Kingdom, a great Tempest Ultimate despite the initiation from the Hellborn team. However, in the end, the Hellborn team still has a tower push going on right here, and they're going to start applying some pressure to the tower. Behemoth kind of doing some running around as great aim popping up right in the middle of my screen. Anyways. Legion team, though, they do hold off on the secondary tower, and it looks like Online Kingdom, or excuse me, SK Gaming, they're going to end up falling back, and maybe wait for another Conqueror kill, because why not? Just sit back and farm, wait for the next Conqueror. You have the advantage to do it, again, how fast you could drop him, as well as being Hellborn, so that's very likely what we may see here from the Hellborn team. Have yet to see the, oh my god, Pestilence, by the way. Decided to kind of stay up the top lane with not much life, and well, Dr. Repulsor took complete advantage of that and ends up dropping him. But as I was going to suggest, despite those portal keys being picked up, we haven't seen that very powerful team initiation between Tempest and Behemoth yet. We're really waiting to see if they can combo that off, and because they really do have the potential to get a nice genocide right here on this Hellborn side, so. Still waiting for that opportunity to come about. But again, SK Gaming at the same time, they of course have that in mind. They're not going to be completely clumped up in these team fights. They're going to be spread out. Look at this. Oh, Behemoth jumps. Oh, but a portal key reaction right there as well. I believe it was Witchslayer. Soulstealer, though, he runs in with the Shrunken Head. Peace is called. And I'm guessing they're talking to Kabop right here. He tries to pour it out. Is he going to be successful? No, the Soulstealer ultimate helps take care of it as well as the Bubbles ultimate. So, wow. He did actually make them use quite a bit right there. Not the longest cooldowns necessarily, but he did make them use both a Soulstealer and a Bubbles ultimate just to kill a Behemoth.
Yeah, but at the same time, they burned the Behemoth ultimate and didn't get anything out of it, which is a much bigger deal in the end. The Bubbles ultimate, very short cooldown. It'll be up shortly after Tempest's ultimate is back up. It's really not that big of a use. The Soulstealer ultimate maybe a little longer, but at the same time, he's also got all that wonderful physical damage to come out with in a team fight. Especially because he's getting, of course, the classic powerful Soulstealer farm. Angry Testy, always known as one of the best farmers in Han, and he's sitting at 485 gold per minute.
That he is, as Hellborn team. Or which Witchslayer, at least. He's making his way to the bottom lane. Oh, he's going to try to pick off Corrupted Disciple. Ooh, but he guesses completely wrong right there. And Corrupted Disciple will get away. And the Ice Man picked up on him right there. And now the Illusions doing their thing against this Witchslayer. Kind of having him hide in the forest right there. And Andromeda getting caught at the bottom room, but going to be fine. Oh, I got distracted. I was like, oh my god, what's going on down here? But yeah, it's just the Illusions. They're just doing their thing down there, so. Yeah, I mean, what could have been, a fairly quick game, to be honest, is turning out to be, at least a solid, comeback here somewhat from Online Kingdom. SK Gaming, they do still have the advantage. That Soulstealer, he is getting very, very powerful. Again, he's had that Geometer's Bane Ice Brand for a while now. He currently has, he just bought something, so we'll see what, if he looks to turn that into a Frost of Skull, or what route he decides to go. In fact, he just dropped it, so yeah, Frost of Skull right there. Okay, so Soulstealer has a Frost of Skull, Geometer's Bane, Shrunken Head, amongst his other items. 36 minutes into the game, obviously 486 gold per minute. That will help you get there. So very, very powerful start here for Angry Testy, especially as we really always see playing on the Soulstealer this time. So That's, again, just really scary for Online Kingdom. And Corrupted Disciple, though, you know, he's trying his best to keep up as much as possible. Only farming 280 gold per minute, though. And while Loda on Storms, or excuse me, Dr. Repulsor, he actually picks up an Acolyte Staff. So, now what is he going for? Interesting. Because he had the Sustainer initially.
I would think he's going to split the Sustainer and get a...
Yeah, Sheepstick.
And get a Sheepstick out of it. And then he can always get something else with the Life Tube and the Sustainer later. I don't know if he was just going for the extra regen while he was still trying to farm up. And we do see, actually, Witch Slayer getting initiated on down here by Corrupted Disciple. He's going to chase him down with a Shrunken Head and the Ice Brand. Very, very easy pickup for him right there. Nice job. Caught Witch Slayer. Definitely overextended there. Way, way past the river. No, they didn't have enough vision. And Corrupted Disciple, I mean, just his passive combined with Ghost Marcher is much faster than most heroes in the game once you have that set up. So you can't expect to run away from him, especially if he gets the jump on you and just starts stacking that Ice Branch slow.
Yeah, I don't know if that was just screwed up initiation or what, because I missed the beginning of that, but I have a feeling that Bubbles was supposed to join Witch Slayer with him, but didn't go in time, and Corrupted Disciple just completely turned that around. So either that, though, or he just was overextended and Corrupted Disciple picked him off. Either way, you know, just bad decision-making from SK Gaming right there. Tobacco's clearing up these ancient creeps right here, dropping fairly low, but has Andromeda nearby, and of course that Minus Armor's helping him quite a bit, and he's going to drop them and take care of that. Nearly 3,000 gold saved up for Pestilence right now. You see him changing his steam boots, as any good competitive player would do, and talk about convenience right there. Regeneration rune happens to spawn at the bottom rune, and well, he just sports on top of it, picks it up, and who cares? He doesn't need to go back to base. He can just continue to farm. So, as I've said several times now, curious as well to see what he goes for in this case. Now that he has his Shrunken Head Portal Key duo, you know, something like a Shield Breaker. I would love to see that, you know, with all the Minus Armor they already have. Demonic Breastplate is obviously another definitely very valid option. We will see, though, which route he decides to take. Right now, though, again, I'm still waiting for the opportunity from the Legion team. I don't know, it's them, not necessarily that they aren't playing aggressive enough, but kind of to an extent, because I just don't see them being able to out-farm this Hellborn team, not only with the heroes that they have, but with the pace that they're on right now compared to the Hellborn team. So, honestly, the Legion team, they really need to get in gear in terms of playing aggressive, looking to push. Wow, Conger just spawned right there, right as Corrupted Disciple ran into the pit. So, obviously, both teams hanging around this area.
Look at Fog. Look at him waiting there to set up on them if they go in. Oh, I didn't get a chance.
He got spotted, though. So he had to port out, unfortunately. He was ready, though. That would have been huge. But yeah, so this is where it's difficult, because frankly, well, both teams have to stay. I mean, if one team goes in, you're going to be clumped up, and that is a huge advantage for the opposing team with these makeups here. So this is where, now that both teams are very aware of the situation, although the Legion team doesn't have wards over here, the Hellborn team does have a couple of wards that we see, of course. Well, not just one, actually, right here, but you know, both teams really want that Conqueror kill, but it's going to be very, very, very difficult. More so difficult, though, for the Legion team, in my opinion, because the Hellborn team, they can at least drop him really fast, as we've seen several times now. And this time, it will drop Bananas as well, so even that much more important, of course, to get that Conger kill. In the meantime, though, load on Dr. Repulsor, picking off the top tower, but oh, he's in a lot of trouble now. He gets caught right here. Can he get the Shrunken Head activated? No, he cannot. Just chain CC. That's even with the Shrunken Head. If you get locked down from the beginning, there's just absolutely nothing you can do. And, well, he ends up getting picked off. So, again, just great play right there from SK Gaming. Easily take him out. Bubbles might be in trouble. No, he uses the takeover. He uses the ultimate then. And here comes a turnaround. Now, Soulstooth also running in. There goes a Comet stun, or excuse me, Comet ability coming out from Tempest. Bubbles porting in. He's trying to chase this Glacius, but he needs to be careful himself. Oh, but he does jump in, though. Gets to kill Glacius. And, well, in the end, SK Gaming, or excuse me, Online Kingdom, they're really spread out. And they're not going to be able to do too much. So, again, Online Kingdom, it just seems like they're not looking to, you know, get in these team fights. And right now, this is where SK Gaming, oh dear God, that was even without Pestilence. Not that Pestilence is here. The Swarm goes up, and it's just amazing how fast he drops. Oh dear God. So Pestilence gets the banana, Soul Shooter this time taking the token of life. And, oh man, with the farm that they have right now, even with the powerful team fight initiation from the Legion team, I just don't know anymore. It's going to be tough now.
Yeah, it's definitely on the difficult side. We see Pestilence porting in on top of the Behemoth Illusion. They still can get the initiation off. They still can pick off key heroes, but at the same time, the heroes they really need to pick off are such high levels and have great survivability compared to most of the Legion side heroes. We do see Corrupted Disciple getting caught out. Nice Behemoth ultimate. Very, very nice. Shrunken Heads going off all over the place. Glacius ultimate. Tempest gets Stormstreeted before he can get anything off. Nice Soul Stealer ultimate taking out two heroes. Dr. Repulsor also going down. Hellborn taking that kill. Corrupted Disciple kind of booking it, but Pestilence looking like he wants to blink in on top of him. If he gets the cooldown, but he doesn't quite get in range because of the Tempest stun.
Oh!
Nice support from Tempest. Nice swap from Andromeda.
You're a couple seconds behind, actually, but Tempest jumped in right there at the very end and got the Tempest ultimate off, catching both Pestilence and Andromeda to finish them off. So I was going to say throughout the whole fight, God, Tempest did not even get the chance to use his ultimate. That is huge. They need to have that ultimate. But, well, again, overextension from SK Gaming results in what ended up being a decent ultimate to catch them. But still, you know, if SK Gaming wasn't playing overextension like that, it definitely, honestly, still think that Tempest, you have to use your ultimate early in those team fights. I mean, I understand that maybe not been the greatest opportunity, but you just, if you're not going to use the Tempest ultimate, you cannot expect to win these team fights. As simple as that. You need to at least try, in my opinion, but he never found the open spot. He never felt comfortable, so, well, he saved it, and as I said, in the end, he actually ended up getting a couple of kills with it, perhaps, but if it wasn't for a crazy overextension from SK Gaming, you definitely wouldn't even have the opportunity. So, but Pestilence, he did use his bananas as well, so they got that taken care of, but they still have now the token of life to worry about here on Soulstealer, of course. Let me do a quick sync up once again. Again, as I said, it seemed like you were a couple of seconds behind. In-game timer, I'm currently at 43, 43, 44, 45,
I'm good.
46. Okay. Soulstealer applying some pressure to Corrupted Disciple up here. Just the illusions, though. And you see just the illusions. I mean, not doing a hell of an amount of damage, but they are dropping him fairly fast. And in fact, Corrupted Disciple, he's just running away rather than trying to turn around on that. What is he doing here? Oh, the destroy right there from the Dr. Repulsor. The finish line goes up on the Tablet of Command just beyond the river right there. Here goes the Storm Spirit, though, for Bubbles. Oh, what a story! Excuse me, the Silver Bullet comes out, takes out Glacius just before Witchslayer went down. He says, I'm taking you with me, buddy. And that surely he did. Pestilence poured in, but runs away immediately after jumping on a Tempest right there. Fissure Stun coming out once again, blocking Pestilence. Here comes a stun from Tempest, but I do not see them following up. Meanwhile, that back here, is that a real Soulstealer? Yes, it is. Soulstealer running in. Ball Shrunken Head's activated. He's good. Oh, yeah, I was going to say, what would that do? He has a Shrunken and Corrupted Disciple nearby, and that's it. So that would have been a pretty worthless ultimate, but Angry Testy notices that immediately, and he cancels it right away. So a really scattered fight right there between both teams. But again, the foot is on the pedal here for SK Gaming. They are not relieving any pressure right now, and they are really keeping it up. So, but at this time, they're actually going to port back once again. And Demonic Breastplate being worked on the Pestilence. So, yeah, again, they have a huge farming advantage. They don't necessarily need to look to finish this game at this minute. So, by all means, they can afford this of sitting back, picking up their farm, and then eventually just overwhelming the Legion team. With Legion team, they're just trying to make anything possible happen. Corrupted Disciple, he does have a Geometer's Bane now. He has an Ice Brand. So, you know, he's going the same route pretty much as a Soulstealer. But he's just one step behind, unfortunately. We got the 521 gold per minute now on Soulstealer. It just keeps on shooting up compared to the 333 on a Corrupted Disciple. So yeah, again, comfortable position here for SK Gaming. They do not need to rush anything. And as a result, they are going to take their time.
Soulstealer just bought an entire Rift Shards for. So he's got that for him now.
Ouch.
Yeah, and on top of all that, minus armor already.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see here. If once they have just the swarm debuff on any of these Legion heroes, I'm looking around at their armor values. Any of these Legion heroes is negative armor just from the Pestilence ultimate. When you combine that with the Andromeda Aurora and the Soulstealer aura and the soon to be the Demonic Breastplate, and actually the Demonic Breastplate right now, they're gonna be in like the negative 10, negative 15, almost negative 20 armor range, and that's just at least a 30, 40, 50% damage boost. It's gonna be absolutely brutal with this Soulstealer. Let's see here, Soulstealer based. damage 330. Combine that with about a 2.5 crit. That comes out to about 750 crits. A little less, a little more. This is fast math.
Yeah.
But it's going to be really brutal, because that's going to be, with the damage bonus, it's going to be 1,000 damage on those crits, at least. More, really.
Yeah, I mean, and yeah, he's going to be hitting very damn hard, and I don't even know, maybe he did, but again, obviously, the Andromeda are just the dimensional link as well. I mean, right now, 386, yeah, 386 max damage for Solstitor with Andromeda nearby. As you said, you add up all the minus armor and the crits that he's doing, yeah, 1,000 would definitely be a likely number. We will see. And again, it goes back to this trio of Pestilence, Solstitor, and Andromeda. We have seen this trio several times. I mean, it kind of surprised me, though, that we haven't seen it more than we have. I mean, we have seen it a couple times in the past, and we always do mention it, of course, when we see it, and it always is so entertaining and just so fun to watch. But it doesn't seem like we see it a whole lot, but it is so, so powerful, as once again, SK Gaming is showing right here. And, yeah, with the Demonic Breastplate pickup, and I honestly wouldn't be surprised if he's like, yeah, hell, I'm going to go for a Shrunken Head, or excuse me, a Shield Breaker next, just because I can. So we will see if that is the case. But for the time being, the Legion team, you know, as we suggested, it's really, they cannot play the farming game at this point. They just can't. They need to make something happen. They need to get the team fight going. They need to somehow catch SK Gaming off guard completely and pick them off, you know, maybe one by one, get a couple of picks, and then push. But right now, SK Gaming, they're not allowing that to happen. They're all clumped up here in the middle lane. And, you know, maybe another Conqueror attempt is going to be waited for. 3 minutes remaining on the token alive. So, of course, that is how long before we have the next Conqueror attempt. Solstitor, they're picking up a Hastrin right there. Oh, well, look at this. The Legion team initiates. Dr. Pulsar jumps it on the Witcher. Witcher dropping fast. Witcher will go down. Behemoth follows up as well. Solstitor uses the Shrugged Head. And look at how much damage he's hitting for. Corrupted Disciple stood absolutely no chance. Pestilence got a decent ultimate off, actually. Pestilence taking a lot of damage. Excuse me, Tempest got a decent ultimate off. But Angry Test here. Just too powerful. Quad kill coming out. And the sole survivor is Tempest. They have a swarm in. They know where he is. Pestilence points it all, but the portal key immediately from Tempest right there. Solstitor, you know he wants the annihilation, though. Can he get there in time to clean it up? Tempest cannot pull it out. It looks like he's stuck, even. He is stuck right there. Here comes Pestilence, and the bubbles gets the kill. They don't allow Solstitor to get the annihilation. Oh, that is so unfortunate, though, for Tempest right there. He got stuck. Whatever the stupid thing is right here, he put it right in between, and he could do absolutely nothing. He was probably going to die anyways. Again, the swarm was on him, so yeah. But still funny to watch. But clean up fight right there for the Hellborn team.
Amazingly, even though this is definitely SK's game, that it's pretty much done at this point. Beautiful genocide. Amazing, amazingly clutch play by Samiju. He had a bound eye for counter warding. He knew he was stuck. He dropped it. He killed it before he lost ownership of it, before it became a free item.
It actually is. I noticed he dropped something. I don't know what he was. Maybe he was, I thought he may have been trying to get a homecoming stone or something, but that is actually kind of funny. Yeah, I mean, that's a heads-up play, but yeah, at the same time, it's like, well, that's smart and all, but...
It doesn't really matter, yeah. But still, it's one of those real clutch things that's actually real cool, even though they're losing. It's not something you think would happen in almost any game, but yeah, really, really heads-up play there.
Very true. So they're electing to do uphill attacks, actually dropping really fast. I think it's Angry Test. It's like, you know, I want you to kill me because I want to resurrect and come right back like he's going to do right here. He has an ultimate ready. He's going to use it off to the side. Not maximum damage, but it does still do a decent amount. He got a couple of kills right there. There's another kill, another hat trick coming out for Soul Stealer. The Vulture Z comes out, and just like that, SK Gaming is your victorious winner here. So they take game one here in this best of three series here in the Gosu Gamers losers bracket. Wow, just the minus armor just once again comes through, and Solstitor was hitting way too hard to deal with at the end right there. And well, Online Kingdom, they figured that out. So very interesting strategy here from Online Kingdom. We always encourage variance in terms of strategies, in terms of pickups that they definitely had, you know, with the Tempest, with the Corrupted Disciple. But well, unfortunately, in the end, they couldn't get the AoE to work out all too well for them. They fell behind early on and ultimately really cost them the game. So that's going to do it, though. Game 1, Ghost SK Gaming. Game 2 going to be coming up next. But your final thoughts here on Game 1, Hippie?
I think the Tempest needed the earlier Portal Key, needed to gank more. I think that it may not have changed the game, but at the same time, it was they took a very early advantage with the Portal Key Pestilence, then they kind of threw it away a little, and then the Tempest, even after they made that big, stupid push that almost cost them their huge advantage, their huge lead, OK Gaming, they didn't have the Portal Key to follow it up on Tempest, and Tempest with a Portal Key, it's not just the ultimate, he's just such a powerful ganker overall, and I think they could have done a lot more with that.
Yeah, it was unfortunate that we never really got to see that combination there from Behemoth and Tempest that can be so, so powerful. But, you know, it's a reason, perhaps, why we haven't seen those style of pickups, you know, those huge AoE style of pickups in a long time, simply because teams, they know how to work against them, they know how to play against them, they know how to prepare for them, they know what items to get, and, well, it just, SK Gaming showed that right here. They just never allowed Online Kingdom to really get that opportunity in terms of taking advantage of what they had. So, but yeah, great play. 1-0 series lead though for SK Gaming. So game 2 going to be coming up next here in the Gosu Gamers Losers Bracket semifinals. Again, you're tuning into the Honkast Daily Cast here on Monday. This doing a recap here of the weekend tournament or the weekend matches that happened. And today we are doing again SK Gaming versus Online Kingdom here in the Gosu Gamers. So stay tuned. Game 2 coming up next. We'll be right back with that.